tap changing transformers, why tap changing is required? Normally, this tap changing is required to control the voltage. How to control the voltage? By changing the number of turns. By varying the number of turns, we can get the variable voltage. Okay. So these taps are generally provided on the high voltage side. Why the taps are provided on the high voltage side? Because high voltage side, the current is less. So therefore, the current, while tapping, the current interrupted will be less. So that's why taps are generally placed on the high voltage side. So there are two types of tap changing transformers, off load, on load. The name itself indicates off load means you have to disconnect the transformer from the supply and change the tap, then reconnect manually. On load tap changing transformer means, so during the supply, when the load is connected to supply, you have to change the tap. Let us see that. So we can have voltage variation in the power system is a normal phenomena due to rapid growth. Okay, voltage variation in the power system is a normal phenomena due to rapid growth of industries and the distribution network. You have to vary the voltage. It needs variable voltage. So for this, the system voltage control is essential. What for? Adjustment of the consumer's terminal voltage within prescribed limits. So we have to adjust the voltage within the limits. Limits means plus or minus 5% variation. Maximum voltage. It should not vary above or below. Next, the control of real and reactive power flow in the network. So if you want to control the especially reactive power, should vary the voltage. That means it is a more absorption of the reactive power, more voltage to be supplied. Less absorption of the reactive power, then voltage should be reduced. So that is very important phenomena. That's why voltage variation is required. So turns ratio of the transformer is varied for achieving tap changing. So to get the tap changing, N2/N1, the turns ratio change must be done. So let us see this offload tap changing transformer. As I said, offload means we have to first de-energize the transformer. That means the transformer must be disconnected from the main supply. Then the tap changing should be done manually. Then again, reconnect the transformer. So let us see this procedure. Hello. The primary side, there is an option to change the turns. That means number of turns to be included can be changed so that the secondary output can be obtained. Let us see how this will happen. So it is required to de-energize the transformer before changing the tap. I'm taking the same example. I will explain you with this. Okay. So if you see this picture here on HT side, we have taps. So presently the tapping is at 1 and 2. That means 1 means this entire section is included, and 2 means this entire section is included. So that means total high voltage winding is in the secondary side. If it is at 1 and 2, that means 100% winding is in the secondary side. Now I want to change this tap to 2-3. 2-3 means what? 2 means this bottom part. 3 means, if you take 3 means this part. Okay. 3 means, you see this 3 line. 3 means this part. That means only this part of the winding. This part of the winding plus total bottom part. It is around 97.5% of the total winding is included here. 97%. If I move this tap to 3-4 means, you can see 4 means this bottom part, 3 means this upper part. So how it will happen, I will tell you. So 4 means this bottom part, 3 means this upper part. That means around 95% of the total winding is included. Like that, if I keep at 4 to 5, 92.5%. If I keep at 5 to 6, 90% of the winding will be taken into consideration. So how this tapping should be done? As I said, so it is an off-load tap changing transformer. It is mainly used for seasonal variations. First, the transformer should be de-energized. That means the supply should be cut first. After supply is switched off, then when the arm is at 102, that means full circuit is included, then bring this arm to 2-3 position. At this position, supply is already switched off. 2-3 position, then you switch on the supply. Okay, again switch on the supply. Now, as I said, 97% of the winding is included. This bottom part and top this part. Again, if you want the tapping at this position, again switch off the transformer. Move this tapping to 3 and 4, then switch off. So like this, we can move this arm between the different struts so that the amount of the winding, a number of turns on the secondary can be varied. We'll get a variable voltage. I think you understand this. So let us see on-load tap changing transformer. The name itself indicates, as I said, the supply may not be interrupted. The on-load tap changing transformer will be used for that case. So here, if you see, such a transformer is called tap changing under load transformer. While tapping, two essential conditions to be fulfilled. Because supply is continuously given, you are changing the taps. While changing the taps, while moving from one tap to other tap, definitely the current will be interrupted. You can expect a spark from that. If it's a high voltage transformer, then you can see large spark, that is called arc. Arc means a heavy spark. So it is of thousands of Kelvin temperature will be there. So load circuit should not be broken to avoid arcing and prevent the damage of the contacts. Because while moving from one position to other position, when these contacts are subjected to heavy currents, they will be damaged. That should not be done. No parts of the winding should be short circuited while adjusting the tap. So these two should be taken into consideration. So let us see this one example of this, how we have changed here high voltage winding with a reactor midpoint tapping, and here these are the different taps and this is connected to this bottom part. So total high voltage winding, this part and this part combinedly high voltage winding, here we kept taps and we have one diverter switch. Let us see how it operates. The tap changing employing center tap reactor shown in the figure. Here S is a diverter switch, 1, 2, 3 are selector switches. So the transformer, initially the transformer is in operation with the S and 1 is in operation. S1 closed. Now the supply is like this with through S1. It is good. Entire winding is there. Now I want to move. I want to select these many turns. Only these turns. That means I want to open the 1 and close 2 so that the power supply, that means the current will flow in this direction. Therefore, these turns will be in the circuit. Then what is the procedure? The first step is to change the position to open the switch S, open the switch S and close the switch 2. Then open the switch 1, then close the switch S. Again, I'm telling, first open the switch S, close the switch 2, then open 1, then close S. Now the power supply is through S and 2 like this. Okay, so what you have to observe here is the diverter switch operates on load and no current flows in the selector switches during the tap changing. And that means when you are changing from 1 to 2, there should not be any current flow in this. That's why we have opened this diverter switch. What is the use of this reactor? So half of the reactants will be included, which limits the current connected to the circuit. So for that, it is used. Let us see one beautiful animation of this one on-load tap changing transformer. So on-load tap changing transformer is done while transformer is delivering the load. As I said, operating efficiency of electrical system is improved because we are not disconnecting the supply and reconnecting the supply. So that's why efficiency will be more. and it is fitted with almost all power transformers. Let us see this. First, observe this animation. See this. Observe the animation. Yeah. Now I will tell you how it is working. Now, initially, when the position of this arm at A, when it is at A, 2 is closed, 3 is open. When you want to move to this position, 3 is closed and it is moved to this position, 2 is open. Again, when it is moved this side, 2 is closed, 3 is open. When it is moved to this side, 3 is closed, 2 is open. So that means if you want to select 2, this is closed, then the flow is in this direction. All the turns will be considered like this. Okay. If you are choosing this switch, only these many turns are taken. That means these turns are not considered. So why this number of turns selected will be less? Okay. So these are the different circuits that you can observe. You see, when it is at the position A, 2 is closed, these turns are considered. When it is moving from A to B, then first you close the 3 because I want 2 and 3. I'm focusing on 2 and 3. Like that, other switches first close 3. When 2, 3 are closed, then it will come to the center. Then the power supply, that means the current is flowing through these turns and then again through this. And that means these turns, the current is flowing. And these turns also current is flowing. That means the supply is not interrupted. The load is continuously connected to the supply at this position. When it is moved to this position B, then this 3 is closed anyway. The supply is through these many turns, 2, 3, it will go like this. Other side anyway, it is disconnected. Then you can open the switch too. So this is on load tap changing transformer. That means there should not be any interruption, there should not be any RC. The current should not be interrupted. That's why this position, mainly why it is connected like this. There should not be sudden change from A to B. If there is a sudden change from A to B, the current is interrupted. You can observe a spark or arc. So that's why it is maintained like this. After that, it is moved this side. Then the current is diverted like this. So this is on load tap changing transformer. You can see this explanation. This diagram also. So a simple explanation. I said the tap changer is used for daily or short period voltage alternations, and the output voltage can be regulated without any supply interruption. So during the operation on load tap changer, you can observe here, I want to move from 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, like that, so that the number of turns selected will be varied. So for example, in this set, I want to move from 1 to 2. What are the steps required? You see, if I want to move from 1 to 2, initially these many turns, all the turns are included. The first step is open switch Y. You see here, open switch Y. And the current flow will be through X like this. It is maintained. Then move this arm B to position 2. Move this arm B to position 2. It is in the open position still. The current is still flowing in this direction. Now close switch 2. Then this current is through these number of turns and these many number of turns, as we have seen in the previous case. So the current is supplied through all the turns like this, not interrupted. Now open X. Okay, now the current is flowing through 2, Y and this position. Then move this position to 2, then close X. So this is the way, by taking all the 5 steps, then we can move the arm from 1 to 2 without interrupting the current. Okay. So the number of turns can be changed. So the center tap reactor, we are using one center tap reactor here. See, it prevents the tapped winding from getting short circuited. Otherwise, there is a short circuit current flow. These two currents will flow like this. They will be short circuited, and both are connected like this. They will be short circuited. So that's why these two will be short circuited if this is not there. Then what happens? The current flow like this, current flow like this. Then this winding will be short circuited by this closed loop. So that's why we are going to have a center tap reactor. So this is about the tap changing transformers. Let us go ahead with the discussion of the three-phase transformers. You are going to get an idea on the three-phase transformers, different types of connections, why they are needed, what are the various types of connections, and other things we are going to discuss, advantages compared to single-phase transformers. So a three-phase, why it is required? It is used to generate and transmit large amount of power. Three phase is required. Three phase transformers are required to step up and step down the voltages in the various stages of the power system network. Okay. So transformer for three phase circuits can be constructed in any one of the following ways. How to construct the three phase transformer? Either with three single phase transformers can be used to construct the three phase transformer, or single three phase transformer unit. Single three phase transformer unit will be used, in which core and windings for all three phases are combined in a single structure. There are two ways to get the three phase transformer. Let us see the pros and cons of all these things. So before going to the three phase transformer, one must have idea about the polyphase. What is polyphase? It's a combination of two or more single phase voltages having same magnitude and frequency, but displayed by one another by equal electrical degrees, that means 120 degrees, like that. That is called polyphase. So we must have idea about phase sequence. What is phase sequence? You see, A, B, C, or R, Y, B. How can you say R, Y, B phase sequence? The magnitude of the phase appears in that order. The magnitude of A comes first, peak value, therefore phase A, next B, next C. So phase sequence is the order of in which the voltage and the three phase attain their maximum value is called phase sequence, or phase of RYB, RBY. It all depends on that. But it's phase voltage, voltage between one of the phase and neutral terminal is called phase voltage. You know that. So what is the phase current? The current flowing in any of the phase winding is called phase current. You should have this idea before going to discuss about the connections. What is the line voltage? The voltage between any two phases of the supply is called line voltage. It is represented by VL. What is the line current? The current flowing through any two phases is termed as line current. So let us see this picture. In this we can observe. So suppose it is a three phase voltage or current. If you take the voltages diagram, let us take 100 volts is the phase voltage. Like this, they are connected at the one point. They are displaced by 120 degrees each. So this is the A, B, A, B, 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 C. So what is the B, A, B line voltage? 100 into root 3. We know that line voltage is equal to root 3 times of phase voltage. Again, line voltage, they are displaced by 120 degrees each. So 100 into root 3. So this is the way you can understand the relationship between voltages and currents. Okay. Let us go to the discussion of three-phase transformer and its construction. So we can observe a three-phase transformer here. Three-phase transformers are more economical for supplying large loads, okay, and a large power distribution. So most of the utilization equipments, they are connected with single-phase transformers, but they are not preferred for large power distribution, because for large power distribution, single phase transformers are not economical. We need three phase transformers. The three phase power is used in almost all fields of electrical power, such as generation, transmission, distribution, large industries. We need three phase power. Also, all the industrial sectors are supplied and connected with the three phase system. So that's why three phase transformer is very much essential. So this three phase transformer is used for step up as well as step down. Where step up is required? At generating station side. We need step up of the voltage. I will discuss that. where step down is required on the utilization side. Step down is required. So as compared to the single phase transformer, there are numerous advantages with the three phase transformer. What is the advantages? They are smaller. Single three phase transformer unit is smaller compared to three single phase transformers connected for three phase supply, and lighter to construct for the same power handling capacity. They have better operating characteristics. You can see here a three phase transformer core type, and I will explain these connections also. You can see the phases RYB, primary connected to RYB, secondary connected to RYB, and there will be one neutral terminal. It is generally delta star connection. We can see like that. So next, you see, as I said, generation side normally the voltage, maximum voltage generated is 11 kV in our India, sometimes 22 kV. But we are transmitting the power in terms of 132 kV, 400 kV, 765 kV, 1000 kV. Like that, the transmission is in terms of thousands of kilovolts. But generation is only 11 kV. Even utilization side also, if you see, we'll take that 11 kV feeder. Generation side 11 kV, utilization side 11 kV. But why this much high voltage transmission is required? In order to reduce the transmission losses. How the transmission losses are reduced? Because power means voltage current. If voltage is more, then what happens? The current rating will be less. Conductor size can be reduced. When the current rating is reduced, then the losses can be reduced. That's why always it is a practice to transmit high voltage through the lines. When you are generating 11 kV, when you want to transmit the power at 400 kV or 132 kV, what you need to do, you have to step up. First, you have to step up the voltage and connect to the transmission. Again, in the load side, you have to step down the voltage. Then you have to replace. So for all these things, we need transformers. Then generation is a heart. Then the transformer, it is very much required to utilize the generation power properly. Okay, so that's why to step down and step up, all these things, this three-phase transformer is required. As I said, the three-phase transformer can be built in the bank of three single-phase transformers or single three-phase transformer unit. So what is the use of three single-phase transformers when they are connected to form the three-phase transformer? So generally, we'll take the three single-phase transformers of same rating, same operating characteristics will be taken to form three-phase transformers. What is the main use? What is the main use of three single phase transformers? Whenever any fault occurs in any one of the transformers, if one transformer fails, other two transformers can supply the power. That is called open delta connection. We'll discuss that. So that means out of three, if one fails, other two transformers will supply the power. That means there is a reliability of the power supply. And that means there is a continuity of the supply will be there. That is the advantage of three single phase transformers. They are connected to form three phase transformer. Mainly these are used in main mines because it is easier to transport individual single phase transformers. Coming to the second one, single unit of three phase transformer. What is the use? The main use is, as I said, it can be constructed with a single three phase transformer consisting of six windings on the both the sides, 3+3. On a common multi-legged core. Due to this single unit, weight as well as the cost reduced as compared to three units of the same rating also. Because when you have three separate transformers of different ratings, when you are connecting to form a three-phase transformer, it occupies more place, more weight, and the cost will be more. So that can be reduced. And amount of iron in the core and insulation materials are saved differently. It is a single core. Space required to install the single unit is less compared to three unit banks. But the main problem is, if there is any problem in the three-phase transformer, then what happens? Entire power supply will go. So that is the disadvantage is there. So, but only disadvantage, as I said, if a fault occurs in any one of the phase, entire unit must be removed from the service. So let us see that. Construction of the three-phase transformer. So we can see different types of three-phase transformers, as just like single-phase transformer. core type, shell type. Coming to the construction, can be constructed using common magnetic core for both primary as well as secondary windings. You can see, this is for one phase primary, secondary. Y phase, B phase, same magnetic core will be used for both primary and secondary windings. Just I have seen in the single phase transformers, core type or shell type. So to form a three phase core type of transformers, we have to take three single core type of transformers. To form a three phase shell type of transformer, we have to take three single phase shell type of transformers. Okay. In shell type of transformers, EI laminated core surrounds the coil. As I said, in shell type generally, core surrounds the coil, whereas in core type, coil surrounds the core. Okay. I have told you which is used for high voltage, which is used for low voltage in the single phase transformers. Next, let us see the core type of transformer. You can observe here three legs, whereas in the single phase two legs are there, primary, secondary. Here there are three legs. Each leg has like has primary and secondary winding here. Okay, there are three limbs or legs and two yokes. Okay, so magnetic path formed between these yokes and the limbs. Each limb, both primary and secondary windings are wounded concentrically because they have same center. Circular cylindrical coils are used as the windings are for this transformer. Okay, the primary and secondary windings of one phase are wounded on one leg. Under balanced condition, the magnetic flux in each phase of the leg add up. Balanced condition, this flux due to primary and secondary, this flux will be added up. Balanced, unbalanced, you know, balanced means 120 degrees phase angle between all the phases. Unbalanced means that 120 degrees phase angle will be missing, so it leads to unbalanced currents. You know, in the three phase circuits, you have studied about this balanced, unbalanced three phase circuits. Therefore, under normal condition, no return leg is needed. But in case of unbalanced loads, high circulating currents flows, hence it may be best to use three single phase transformers. Unbalanced loads, it's better to go for three single phase transformers in place of single three phase transformer unit. So you can see this one. This is a core type of transformer, practical picture, three legs for three phases. So here you can see the three legs like this. They are connected to common point here. And here, central limb is removed. This is the central limb that is removed. How it can be removed, I will explain, because it carries no flux. And this is the usual way to represent the core type of transformer. You can see this is a shell type of transformer. A three phases, shell type, you know, same way as a single phase. The three phases are more independent. They are independent of each other because each phase has independent magnetic circuit. This has different magnetic circuits compared with core type of transformer. This construction is similar to single phase transformers. Magnetic circuits of this transformer are in parallel. These magnetic circuits are in parallel. Due to the saturation effects on the common magnetic circuits are neglected because their parallel saturation effect can be neglected. If you take this three phase transformer, by stacking three single phase shell transformers, this is one, this is one, this is one, like this, by stacking all these things, you can form a shell type of transformer. The winding direction of the central limb, the opposite to that of the units of A and C. In this, it is opposite to the of these two units. Okay, the fluxes will also be balanced. So let us see the working principle of this three phase transformer. We have, so working of three phase transformer, if you see, this is a core type of transformer where you can observe here we have shown only primary winding, secondary winding is not shown for simplicity purpose, and there is a central limb here, a common limb is connected, a central limb is will be there, all are connected at this point. So you can see here the three cores are arranged at 120 degrees each other. The empty leg, this is empty leg where no core is connected, no winding is connected. So that is combined such that they form a center limb. You can see here the working of the transformer, if you observe, when the primary is excited, with the three phase supply source, the currents IR, IY, IB flows. So these IR, IY, IB supplies flux phi R, phi Y, phi B in the respective ports. Okay, they will supply. Since the central leg is common to all the ports, the sum of the three fluxes carried by it, if you take the sum of the three fluxes, will go in the central leg. But in a three phase system, at any instant, the vector sum of the three currents under balanced condition is zero. IR plus IY plus IB is equal to zero. Because the current is zero, therefore flux also zero. That means no flux flows in the center limb. So that's why we can remove the center limb like this, because no flux is carried in this center limb. So that's why this can be modified like this. Likewise, in a three phase system where any two conductors acts as a return for the current in the third conductor, any two legs acts as return path for the flux for the third leg. If the center leg is removed, if the center leg is removed, for any two legs, other one is a return path. Therefore, while designing the three-phase transformer, this principle is used. Three fluxes induce secondary EMF. Then the flux is induced. What will happen? They induce EMFs in the respective phases, such that they maintain the phase angle 120 degrees each other. What the EMF will do? It drives the current in the secondary. That is not shown here. The EMF drives the current in the secondary. Hence, that is connected to the load. Depends upon the type of connection used, the number of turns on each phase, voltage induced will be varied. Because the number of turns, primary, secondary, based on that voltage induced will be there. Based on that, there will be a step up transformer or step down transformer. So we'll continue our discussion with the advantage of three phase over single phase unit, three phase transformer unit, and we'll continue our discussion with the different types of connections